Siobhan, roll the tape.
If someone told me when I was like 6 or 7 years old that someday I'd be standing in a room singing to Usher, I would have been like, shut up. Sorry, I'm wicked nervous. I've been a big fan since I was like, I don't know, 6 years old.
I'm just going to ruin it all today. Oh my God.
He's always one of those artists that when you saw him, you're like, I want to do that. Through the
fire. Siobhan is performing Through the Fire, and she's actually got the voice. I'm glad they risk it all. Through the fire. When I first met you, I would have never thought that you had that voice.
His advice was more about my personal style.
Have you chosen your wardrobe for the day?
Pretty much. It is very relevant to ask that because people think that sometimes my choices are too shocking.
We want to make sure that you don't have so much going on that people kind of get away from, you know, what you have to offer as a vocalist.
I have to do something. I can't just wear like a dress and heels.
What separates Siobhan from the rest of the pack is that she has a very unique vocal ability. Bring it in for the real thing. Come on.
Thank you.
I think that she's got a true shot at being an incredible artist.
Tonight, she's rocking Missy Elliott boots with Chaka Khan's Through the Fire. Here's Siobhan Magnus.
I look in your eyes and I can see love so dangerously. You're not trusting your heart to anyone. When it's this good, there's no saying no. I need you so, I'm ready to go.
I mean, big song. I mean, you definitely got a big voice. I don't know if it quite caught on pitch-wise. It was a little all over the place to me. I don't know if this was one of your shining moments, but I still love the courageousness and the conviction. I mean, only you would have taken on that song. I like the outfit, though. I really like this whole boot thing going on. But, yeah, it wasn't your best performance, babe. It wasn't your best performance at all. Kind of rough.
Yeah, I have to agree with that. I think that there are a couple of, I could see you looking at us when you went off a bit. It's kind of like when you're hiking and you miss the trail and then you're really lost. And it felt like you were kind of going, oh, I'm off, and then you kind of freaked out about it. But I think, you know, to start off the evening with you, it's like dessert before the meal. I loved it. I love you, but I thought it was not your best performance.
Come on, I've got to agree with that. I think you got a little nervous up there tonight, too. And it should have worked for you. Parts of it did, the screaming parts, but the other parts just weren't there. It just, your lower register, it wasn't strong enough. But I have to say, you have delivered pretty much every week. So every performer has an off night, and you're entitled to one. You've been here, you've come through every week, and I have to say, at the end of the day, you know, you're still a great singer.
I'll tell you what it sounded like to me, Siobhan. It sounded to me as if you'd run a marathon and you were singing while you were running out of breath. It was so all over the place. Why would you just boo, which is completely the right, what I just said is the right thing. I think you look all over the place tonight.
I actually like the outfit.
Thank you. I like it, too.
I like the outfit.
But I'm just being honest with you. If this was the first time I'd ever seen you...
But it's not.
No, I know, but I have to imagine that it is. And you're kidding yourself if you think that was a good performance, because it wasn't. And when you hear it back, it's going to sound even worse than you know. It was by far your weakest performance so far, and the song didn't suit you. And I am getting bored of the screaming at the end.
By the way, that coming from the runner of the group, the marathon reference, Simon Cowell. I want you to give people at home the context for choosing that song, because I know that you were most nervous about it. It was a challenge. The advice was to take a risk from the judges. So tell us about preparing for that song.
Probably the hardest song I've chosen so far, and I knew that, but... You know, even if I didn't kill it, I wanted to prove that I was willing to try. Not in that way. I know what you mean.
But did she kill it, Simon? She didn't kill the song.
Well, I meant kill it in a good way.
She didn't crush it, kill it.
I'm going to call it manslaughter.
Ellen,
thank you.
It's a question for you. When they get the feedback to take a risk and do something that's challenging, and then they do something, you know, she does something like that, it almost makes me, if I'm a contestant, fear taking too much of a risk. What advice do you have for her?
You know, I actually am surprised. I thought that you were going to kill that song. I felt like it was the perfect song for you.
Yeah.
I just felt like you went off a couple of places, and then once you went off, you really went off. I think it's a great song for you, and I'm surprised that you thought it was a challenge, because I think your voice can handle that song. But there are a couple of times when you're screaming for a song like that, it's like gilding the lily. I don't know if you know what that term means, but it's like they already have those high notes. So to do that at the end, I felt pushing it too much.
I completely agree. And I think what happened, too, is you were scared and you knew that note was coming and you knew that was coming. And instead of concentrating in the moment of what you were doing, you were building too much. But also, she has delivered every other week.
Right,
we can't
forget that about her. Jack, final thought?
And just trust yourself. You're better than you think. Just trust yourself with these big songs. Listen, we love you. You all heard us say that. You know what I'm saying? And we get into this confusion about taking chances and the song choice. You just got to sing it great, and you could have sung that great. It just didn't happen tonight.
To vote for Siobhan, the number, 1-866-IDOL-01. It's 1-866-436-5701. If you're with AT&T, you can text the word vote to 5701. Lines open at the end of the show. They'll stay open for at least 2 hours. Thank you, Siobhan. Good luck, all right? On the other side, Casey plugs in and takes us back to 1966. More Idol Live next. Hang on.